So why, when we combine water, this single-celled organism called yeast, and sugar, do we get these results? Keeping in mind that right here, this first one was our control. It did not have sugar. And then these four cylinders had different amounts of sugar. So if we take this out on a microscopic level, if this is one yeast cell, this yeast cell is taking in sugar as its food, using that sugar, and then releasing or excreting it as a waste. And in this case, this waste is carbon dioxide. So if we think about this, what basic life process are we thinking about? If we are taking in food, and in this case, sugar, using it to create energy, and then releasing a waste, the basic life process we have here is respiration. So we have a perfect view of yeast cells living, a living organism respiring. And because we have these yeast cells contained within this graduated cylinder, we have our gas being produced, our carbon dioxide, and as it continues to be produced, those molecules begin bouncing around because of this change of matter state, and then they begin pushing that balloon open as the gas begins to produce. So go ahead and think about what we have here, and we will try an experiment soon.